ArmstrongandGettyRadio.com.
Please welcome to the Armstrong and Getty Show, Ian Freeman. He is a member of the Robin Hooders, who are getting a lot of attention in New Hampshire. He's part of the Free State Project. He moved there in 2006. We're actually in touch with some of the folks from the Free State Project to talk to them pretty soon. But Ian, welcome. How are you, sir?
Hey, good morning, gentlemen.
Wait a second. Are you the same dude we talked to the other day that was named Freeman, or are all you libertarians named Freeman now?
I don't believe we've ever talked before.
Okay, so is it
we talked to a Freeman the other day?
We did. Is that a nom de plume for you, Ian?
I did choose that name for myself.
Oh, I like it. We're not gonna.
No, I'm not complaining.
Persecute you for it. It's actually kind of a cool thing, which we get.
We've just interviewed two people this week who are both named Freeman, who are all about. Oh, the guy we talked to, for the other Freeman, was at the court case up in Wisconsin for the Amish farmer and the milk and all that sort of stuff.
His name
was Freeman.
How about
Ian? Did you talk to Derek J?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I love Derek J.
He's
a
good dude.
I produced his movie, Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree.
Yeah, he's a likable guy. So how about Ian? Did you pick that because it's kind of cool and Anglo-file-y, or is that your real name?
No, those were my parents. They did that one.
Oh, okay. They're to blame. Anyway, Ian, so listen, tell us, what were you so-called Robin Hooders doing and what happened?
So Robin Hooding is the act of going to downtown Keene or wherever you could do it in your town in theory, but going downtown, finding the parking enforcement officer, wherever they might happen to be, and then walking in front of that person in order to deposit coins in expired meters to prevent them from writing any tickets whatsoever.
If I weren't such a straight guy, I'd kiss you right on the cheek.
I like the spirit of that for a number of reasons, but why do you do it specifically? What's your message?
Well, I think there's a couple different reasons. One, it's a really nice thing to do for people. I mean, who likes walking out of whatever business they happen to be in downtown, and then there's that sinking feeling in the pit of your stomach as you notice someone has left a parking ticket on your car.
Right, but you can go around and feed meters without doing it right in front of the parking meter person.
You could, but then you wouldn't have saved anyone necessarily from receiving a ticket.
Okay. Right.
And so, you know, we want to stop the tickets from being issued. We want to, or at least I want that, and I want to help people feel good. So instead of feeling that nasty feeling, they feel great when they see the little card that we leave, which has a picture of Disney's Robin Hood on one side. We didn't ask permission for that. And then on the other side...
So you're intellectual thieves as well.
Yeah, and then on the other side it says, your meter expired, but we saved you from the King's Tariff. And then it gives them a little bit of information on how to contribute to your
organization. Great. Hey, listen, I don't want to steal your thunder if you're working in this direction, but I was actually downtown in a large California city by the ocean not long ago. Well, it was San Diego. And I wasn't sure if I could park my car where I wanted to park it.
And it's a Bentley. Joe drives a Bentley.
I do not drive a Bentley. It rolls. And so and I asked, well, how much are the parking tickets? Because I'd gotten a ticket, you know, several years ago, and I think it was $8. And they said it's $45. And so fine, in this enormous cash grab that's going on, where penalties and fines are now multiples of what they used to be, you know, I like the spirit of that, too, because you're not looking at an $8 ticket anymore. I don't know what it is there in charming Keene, New Hampshire, but you're looking at a hell of a cash grab.
It's true, and in a lot of areas, the government has outlawed paying for other people's meters. So if you were to try this in your area, it may actually turn into a criminal act, so your mileage may vary. Here in Keene, New Hampshire, and all across New Hampshire, it is not illegal to do that, and we actually have fairly small parking tickets, but either way, I don't really care what the amount of the ticket is. I want to make somebody feel good and deprive the state of revenue and also destroy the legitimacy of the system while I'm at it.
But are you are you for people being able to park their car just in front of a store for 5 days at a time if they want? I mean, parking doesn't really make me angry.
No, what I'm for is for private property, and I don't think that we need to have the idea of the state in the first place, but certainly if the state's going to exist, I don't think they need to control parking. I think that the market can handle that fine. Let's let businesses own the parking spaces and decide how to allocate them appropriately. I think if business were in charge of parking, we'd have a much better parking situation in any given downtown.
Almost certainly.
Here's where I get overly serious and bore everybody to death. Has the Supreme Court ever spoken to the question of the illegality of paying someone else's meter? I mean, that seems ludicrous. How in the name of Tom Jefferson do you even, I mean, God dang, you could be a communist, and I don't quite get how you justify that thinking.
Well, I mean, the state has made all kinds of things illegal that have never been charged at the or never been seen at the Supreme Court, simply because nobody's challenged it. So I highly doubt that anyone anywhere has ever been arrested or ticketed for feeding someone else's meter, and then has proceeded to go through the court process rather than just paying the ticket.
One
of the other things we do, besides leave the thank you note on people's cards or the cards on people's windows, is if someone's already been given a ticket, we leave an informational flyer which gives them suggestions as to how to handle things through the legal system rather than just paying the ticket.
Right.
We suggest that people clog the court system by demanding their trial. And I don't know what it's like in California. Like, I know in some states they'll charge you ridiculous court costs and they'll make it very difficult to take things to trial. But here in New Hampshire, there's no penalty at all. So this $5 ticket, I can say, well, I'd like to take that to trial. Then they have to schedule a trial. And then, you know, it goes to trial, and they have to spend a bunch of time and effort actually convicting me. And after it's all said and done, it's still just $5.
All right. Ian Freeman's on the line. He's a free stater out in New Hampshire. Hey, listen, we've barely got a minute left. But so what sort of harassment have you guys gotten? What has the city done to you?
Well, they're the ones claiming we're harassing their employees. They're suing us in the local superior court here, which is a ridiculous claim. We've got hours and hours of footage that shows that we treat them with courtesy, and they're the ones that tend to lie and be rude to people. But it's really blown up into an amazing story, and I'm really glad you guys had me on to discuss it. And thanks for plugging the Free State Project. We just had a couple new movers come from California, escaping the tyrannical state there and coming to a much freer place.
It's a banana republic.
You said you don't believe in the state, period. So what do you call yourself? What's your political affiliation?
I like the term voluntarist. I believe all humans should interact with one another on a consensual basis.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Ian Freeman, we will have a link to your blog if people want to check out more of what you've been writing and the Free State Project and the rest of it. Ian, let's talk again sometime, all right?
Anytime you want. You guys are great. I appreciate it.
Keep stirring up the poo, my friend.
Those guys like that we talk to always sound the same. There's something about them.
Yeah, they're always very bright.
I mean, he's way down that road of no government, further down than I am.
All right.
He was sentenced to 93 months in jail.
93 days?
Well, that's 3 months, right?
Oh, I thought you said 93 months.
I started to say days, and I changed to months to make it more clear how long it was. It was my fault. It was a verbal punctuation problem. He was sentenced to a little over 3 months in New Hampshire jail for failure to stand in the presence of a judge who was presiding over his trial. See, I don't get that. I don't have any problem with standing in front of a judge. That doesn't bother me to acknowledge that we have a court system and we have respect for it. That doesn't bother me.
Well, he is, by any definition, an extremist, although he is a peace-loving, gentle extremist in the same way that, like, a Gandhi was an extremist. So... And that's what people always throw at libertarians is you don't want any government at all. You don't want even chaos, anarchy. And, you know, some do. But as he quickly said, look, you know, I don't believe in the state at all. But if you're going to have a state, at least we can rein it in and have a blah, 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 blah. That's not an unreasonable person.
The idea of walking in front of the meter people and putting the money in the meter before they get a ticket is just hilarious.
I love it.
That's funny. What's coming up in your news, Marshall Phillips?
Yeah, we got the latest on the...